is Don O'Malley with Don's Breakfast Cereal Show. Yes, and once again, I get to wear a pith helmet. Today we're showing Jungle Girl, chapters 1 through 5. Death by Voodoo, Queen of the Beast, River of Fire, Treachery, and Jungle Vengeance. This was based on an Edgar Rice Burroughs story called Jungle Girl, written in 1932. This was filmed in 1941. No, it wasn't. What happened? Edgar Rice Burroughs was so popular that they just simply used his name. They used nothing of the story that he had written for this. So we'll be watching this Jungle Girl and also a Commander Cody, episode 1 of his TV show. So we'll be back after that. Thanks again for tuning in.
Leaving the swamps.
Yeah. This must be Simbula Lake.
How does it check on your map?
Oh, there are no maps of this territory, Mr. Latimer.
Oh? This is strictly back of beyond.
So what do you know about this Masamba tribe that's supposed to be living here?
Nobody knows about them. Huh? The story goes that they drifted down here from the Sahara Desert centuries ago. They were friendly, I guess.
Thank you.
sound of those drums.
Me either. Every medicine man in the Simbula jungle is probably making voodoo against us. We may need these.
I don't like this. Well, we're in one piece so far. Let's get onto that village.
Point, I can stop them from getting behind us. Cover me!
Right.
I'm certainly grateful to you.
Why did you come here?
We're looking for a Dr. Meredith.
He's my father. I'll take you to him.
Sorry, but I had to shoot one of your natives.
Who was shot, Shamba?
Tonta. He back in jungle. Shamba make voodoo. He get well.
Do nothing of the kind. Take him to the Dr. Bwana.
Ayak, go ahead.
What is that he's holding, Doctor?
That? Oh, that's the lion amulet. Ancient symbol of the chief medicine man. The natives believe it has curative powers. Before I came here, it was used in voodoo and witch doctor rites.
Are you the tribal medicine man?
Yes. When I arrived, Lutembe, he's the chief, was dying of malignant jungle fever. I cured him, and his father, he was the medicine man, gave me the amulet. It's also a symbol of authority. As long as I have the amulet, I can control the tribe. Put him in the hospital hut, Nyoka.
Mind if I go along?
Of course not.
I suppose you wonder why we're here, Doctor.
Yes, I was coming to that. I am a little curious.
About your brother, Bradley Meredith.
Bradley. What devilment is he up to now?
Your brother's a changed man, Doctor. As you know, he received a long term in prison. He's just recently been paroled.
I owe my brother nothing, Mr. Latimer. Absolutely nothing. His criminal activities drove me into the jungle, forced me to bring my daughter up with a savage tribe. I'm sorry, Latimer, but I can have...
Hear me through, please. Your brother's desperately ill in the Kimba. He's convinced that only you can save his life.
So you've come to take me back with you?
Yes, but only long enough to treat him. After all, he is your brother, and you are a physician.
Oh, I'm not forgetting my Hippocratic oath. But this is different. This man is a murderer.
He's paid for that. Doctor, what name would you give a physician who refused to treat a dying man?
I'm sorry you had to say that, Latimer. Of course. I'll go back with you to Kimberval. But only on one condition. My daughter must know absolutely nothing of this. She doesn't even know I've got a brother.
I understand.
What about your pilot?
Stanton knows nothing of my reasons for coming here. When can we start?
Sometime today. As long as we're going into Kimberval, I may as well get some medical supplies. So I'll have to go to the caves of Nacros to get some of the tribal diamonds. If you don't mind waiting here, I won't be long. I'm flying out to Kimberval this afternoon, Nyoka, but I've got to go to the caves of Nacros first.
The caves of Nacros? I always thought they were another African fairy tale.
Well, there are some fantastic stories, I'll admit, but the caves do actually exist.
I see.
You can see for yourself. We'll all go.
Fine, let's see them.
Looks like an old tomb.
The Masamba found diamonds here. Now they use the caves as a storehouse for the tribal wealth.
What became of the diamonds?
Well, most of them are still in there.
Aren't they guarded?
Oh, yes. Very well guarded, as you'll see. This lion amulet is the passport to the caves of Nacros. These are the lion guards. They're chosen from the bravest men of the tribe.
Yes, I know, but these guards couldn't stop anybody that was armed.
They'd sound the alarm, and others inside have a defensive device that would stop an army.
I see.
Now, here is the real defense. This gate blocks a tunnel that leads into Simbula Lake. It can be flooded in a few seconds. At the same time, the outer gates close automatically, so that anyone in this tunnel will be carried through the cliff and into Simbula Lake. We go up this way. I'm sorry, Stanton, but only the possessor of the amulet may enter the inner caves.
We will wait here.
Amulet sure works. Who gets it when he goes back to Kimberval?
It'll remain here. The natives believe that if it comes in contact with the idol part of the time, it'll regain its strength.
Supposing he doesn't return to claim it.
Well, the lion man will give it to me as his heir. And if anything happens to me, then it goes to Shamba, the witch doctor.
I see.
Anika, Anika Chatana.
I'll be back soon, Lutembe.
Quick soon, Bana. Masamba needs you.
But I must go now. I promised Mr. Stanton that I'd be... Nyoka. My charm, it's gone.
Oh, it's around someplace, Dad. I'll find it. You mustn't keep Mr. Stanton waiting.
But it contains the only picture of you I have.
Don't worry about it. I'll find it.
Goodbye, Lutembe.
Goodbye, Bana.
Tonight I make death voodoo for Dr. Buona.
Fire voodoo, Shamba?
Fire voodoo, Bambu.
Now we go this way. Your brother lives here.
Death come for Dr. Buona. Dead close him now. Much close.
Would you prefer to see him alone?
If you don't mind.
Hello, John.
Bradley. I thought...
that I was dying, huh? We figured that was a certain way to get you here.
Then there's nothing wrong with you?
Well, nothing that a few of your diamonds won't cure.
Oh. So you know about the Nacros diamonds, do you? Then you should know that they belong to the Masamba tribe. But even if I owned them outright, I'd never...
Don't be a righteous fool, John. I've got a plan that'll set us up like kings. Kings, I tell you. You can have anything you want. Instead of living like an outcast with a tribe of shrieking savages...
Those shrieking savages are my friends, and they don't commit murder.
Dr. Buona will die.
Is that all? Isn't that enough?
Yes. For a piece of criminal trickery, that's quite enough. Now you listen to me. The Nacros diamonds will be used for the betterment of the Masamba tribe and nothing else.
If you do anything to block me in getting those diamonds, I... Well, how do you think that precious daughter of yours would like to learn that Bradley Meredith, the man who did time for murder, is your twin brother?
There was a time, Bradley, when I would have done almost anything to avoid that.
But it doesn't influence me now. I'm going to report you to the police.
Tonight. Wait a minute.
Dr. Buona is dead.
Hey, you two sure look alike, don't you?
We should. We're identical twins.
You'd better start calling me Dr. Meredith.
I get it. You're going back to Kairobi and impersonate him.
Then get this. By tomorrow, we'll be back in the jungle after those Nacros diamonds. I'll organize the boys. You arrange for the plane.
Dr. Buona is dead. Now Shamba, medicine man of tribe.
Lion men give Nyoka amulet. She lead tribe.
Then Nyoka die too.
How she die?
In morning, get Kimbo. Bring here. Make more voodoo. Nyoka die too.
Bamba, what is it?
Kimbo, he hurt. You come help?
Where is he?
In jungle. Me show you.
All right, come on.
I've got to fix the ship against the weather.
We'll go on ahead to the village. See you later.
Right.
Did you check everything, Curly?
Everything's okay, Jack. Ready to take off any minute.
Fine, let's get on to the village.
Tide wet, it grow long. Fire make hide dry, it grow short. Hide pull post, Nyoka die in fire.
Make it snappy. Loose. I want that witch down.
Are you all right?
Where's Shamba?
He got away.
I've got to get to the caves of Nacros.
Why?
Shamba thinks he killed my father with voodoo. And he probably believes he killed me with that spear. That means he'll try to claim the amulet. I've got to get to the Lion Men first.
Hey, come up here.
Shamba come for lion amulet. Shamba, medicine man of Masamba now.
Dr. Juana, medicine man of Masamba.
Dr. Buana dead. Nyoka die too. Shamba, medicine man.
You come see lion chief.
Nice timing. I didn't even see that guy.
He's one of Shamba's men. Shamba must be in the cage. We've got to hurry.
Shamba. White man from Devilbert, he come.
White men come to rob.
Save the warrior!
Hey, I come! Come here, get you. Hey, I come!
Jack! The water gates.
Yeah, they're opening. Quick! Nice timing. I didn't even see that guy.
He's one of Shamba's men. Shamba must be in the cage. We've got to hurry.
Shamba. White man from Devilbert. He come.
Hey, I come. Come here, get you. Hey, I come.
How do we get back to Kurobi?
That way. Dad'll be angry to hear that Shamba still has the amulet.
You have to tell him right away?
Of course. He'll know how to deal with Shamba. Why shouldn't I tell him?
Well, this is the first chance I've had to tell you. He had an accident to his head in Kimberville.
Is he badly hurt?
No. It brought on amnesia. He has lapses of memory. But it's just a temporary condition.
I've got to get to him at once.
Sure, you got everything straight.
Yes, I know. I'm the beloved white doctor and the father of Nyoka.
That's right.
You think I can get away with this?
Of course. They won't suspect a thing. You can pull that loss of memory stuff whenever it suits you. Now, listen. The first thing we want is that amulet. We can't get the diamonds without it.
Girl's coming.
Over here.
Is he asleep?
No, just resting. He's been quite worried about you.
Nyoka, my dear.
Dad, are you comfortable?
Yes. But the amulet, Nyoka. I must have the amulet.
Of course, Dad. But you better get some rest now. I didn't want to tell him, but Shamba still has the amulet.
But you and your father are the rightful holders of the amulet. Why don't you get the lion man to take it from Shamba?
It's not as simple as that. Lutembi's father passed it on to us, but you see, the lion men only obey the possessor of the amulet.
This is going to worry your father. It may make his condition worse.
I know. I've got to find some way to get it back. What are you doing?
Kimbu, pray to Lion Goddess. Tell her to take form and make Shamba give amulet back to White Doctor.
Why, that's ridiculous, Kimbu. You know that an idol can't come to life. You shouldn't even come to life.
Nagda Sarimo Kizala Ito.
The Lion Goddess does not want this sacrifice to a false medicine man. My people, Shamba has lied to you. The White Doctor is not dead. The amulet still belongs to him. I have taken form to lead you to Shamba and get the amulet for the Bwana Doctor. Come.
Hold up.
Shamba. I, the lion goddess, guardian of the lion amulet, have taken form as of old to right some wrong that has been done. I have come for the amulet.
But white doctor dead? The amulet is mine.
The white doctor is not dead. Return the amulet, or bring the curse of the lion goddess to the Masamba tribe. You know the legend.
Shamba no legend. It say, she who would be lion goddess must face test of lions.
Shamba, speak truth.
The sacred knife.
Come.
Hi, Kimball.
Kimbu said he saw the lion men taking Nyoka to Shamba's village, and that means trouble. Come on, Curly.
You stay here and watch the plane, Kimbu.
Will be angry for this. We must not let this happen. There must be a sacrifice. Take her to Nakras. I take Nyoka to fire god. Fire, come here.
It ain't that I care about being captured. It's Nyoka that I'm worried about.
You still do that trick of throwing your voice?
Why, yeah. Why?
Now's a good time to try it.
I think I know what you mean.
Help! Help! Let me out of this basket. Come on, you. Let me out. Let me out of this basket, you hear?
Wuggy Lou.
Who do you think it is? Charlie McCarthy.
Oh.
This is the spot where Nyoka and I came out of the caves. We have to swing down to the ledge.
Let's start swinging.
This prop. Thank you.
With Shamba on the warpath, neither the doctor or Nyoka are safe. We have to get out of here.
You're right, Stanton. How soon can you have the plane ready?
We can take off the first thing in the morning.
That's swell. We'll be ready.
Come on, Curly. Have you been hit by jungle fever? What's the idea of moving out without the diamonds?
Take it easy, Brad. I didn't come down here for the ride. We'll get the diamonds.
What? How?
Through Shamba. I think I can make a little deal with him that'll straighten everything out. Sit tight. I'll be back soon. To see Shamba. I have an important message for him. Take me to him. You won't need them. I want to talk to you alone.
Hi, Uncle.
I know you don't like me or any of the other whites around here. Well, I can promise you we'll all leave Simbula tomorrow on the Devil Bird.
White medicine man and Nyoka too?
Yes. But on one condition. You give me those diamonds.
How I know you not trick Shamba? What you give for trade?
What do you want?
Nyoka, I promise to sacrifice to Lion Goddess. She must die.
All right. But I'll need your help to bring her here. Now, you must...
Oh, you're a big help, Kimbu.
Why you go away?
Because the White Doctor's sick.
You come back?
Someday. You help me take these to the plane, Kimbu.
The plane?
Yes.
Might as well keep each other company.
Thank you.
Come on, Kita. Come on.
Shamba's men.
Telegraph.
Thank you.
does. We take her to village. Make sacrifice tonight.
When do I get the diamonds?
Shamba comes to caves at midnight. You meet him there.
All right.
Here comes Kimbo.
Stanton! Stanton! Shamba men take Nyoka.
Where?
Shamba village.
Hurry back to Kurobi and tell the chief what happened. We may need help. Before we can get to her.
Hey, come on.
If any one of you makes a move, Shamba's as good as dead. Cut through the swamp if we can lose him. Come on.
What are we waiting on?
Hold to me. Bring him up. Hey, come on.
This place is covered with oil. We gotta get out of here fast.
Well, what are you waiting for?
We cut through the swamp, maybe we can lose him. Come on.
What are we waiting on?
Talk to me!
Hurry up! Hey, come on!
Well,
what are you waiting for?
God is happy. He kills Shamba's enemy.
Boy, you've been hot one of that time, saved our lives.
We better get back to Cairo. Big Dad will be worried.
Lucky to get away. It's a good thing we decided to leave here. None of us are safe now.
Yes, I suppose you're right. Will you be ready to take off tomorrow?
Well, yes, it won't take long to get the plane ready. Well, I guess we better turn in. Come on, Curly.
Good night.
Good night. I think I'll go to bed too, Dad.
Can I get back yet?
Not yet.
We're in a fine mess. Nyoka got away from Shamba.
What's that?
Latimer. Nyoka's escaped.
That explains why Shamba didn't keep his date with me.
Didn't you get the diamond?
No.
Nyoka and Stanton insist that we fly back to Kimberville tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yeah. How are you going to stay here without their getting suspicious?
for your good friend, Chief Lutembi. With his help, we can fix things.
And Miss Stanton has persuaded the doctor to return to Kimberval until his wounds are healed. Shamba has the lion amulet. And with it, he can cause an uprising that will destroy all the good that you both have done. If the doctor leaves.
What do we do?
If you help me, we can keep him here.
How?
The only way to leave Simbula Swamps is in the great bird that brought us here. If great bird cannot fly, we cannot go.
We're all set. Now, y'all ought to be here pretty soon with the baggage.
Well, while you're cleaning up, I'll load the gas.
Okay.
What's that?
Sounds like a native in trouble. Must be down the trail. Come on.
We're in a tough spot.
Yeah, some hole we're in.
Yeah. Now let's try to get out of here. Come on.
Father Jack.
What's the matter with you, Curly? Go on up.
Jack! I ain't alone up here.
I'll tell you on the way back to the plane.
What I need is an aspirin. Boy, I'll never be caught without this gun again.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
I'll hand the gas down to you, Jack.
Okay.
Is the plane all ready?
We're all set.
Hey, Jack.
Yeah?
The gas is gone, every can of it.
Who could have done that?
I don't know.
They left tracks. I can follow them. Jack?
Yeah?
Quite a few natives pass through here.
There had to be a lot of them to do it.
They need some men to guard the gasoline?
Gasoline guarded by spear trap. Much better.
Had my name on it.
An animal trap.
This wasn't meant for animals. Now I know we're on the right trail.
These kabunas sure have a funny sense of humor.
Entrance to Dark Canyon. It can't be far now.
Shamba! Nyoka, I go to Gala. One at one. But I got a gold! DJ Dwa. Like it's all here.
Yeah.
Hey, Shamba, get back into cover.
Can't stay here long, though. They'll circle us.
Make fire trap. Break up you.
What about the gas?
Look!
got to get out of here. That wind's blowing our way. How are we going to get that gasoline?
Never mind the gas. Let's go.
Trail leads this way. Look!
Shamba, get back under cover. We're safe back up here. They can't get to us.
Yeah, we can't stay here long, though. They'll circle us.
Make fire trap. Where go be?
What about the gas?
We gotta get out of here. That wind's blowing our way. How are we gonna get that gasoline?
Never mind the gas. Let's go.
Shamba and his warriors may still be somewhere around here.
They've never heard an explosion like that in their lives. They'll be deep in the jungle by now.
Yeah, I guess so.
Jack, what are we going to do? We'll never get out of this jungle now. Our gasoline's gone.
Well, there's nothing we can do. Let's get back to Kairobi.
There you are, Jack.
If I could only find the oil deposit that supplies the film that covers these swamps, I could refine enough crude gas to fly us out.
Stanton, you've got to. The only way we can get out of
these swamps... Take it easy, Doctor. You mustn't excite yourself. I suggest you begin to search for that oil immediately.
I know where those seepage pools are. I'll take you to them.
Good. Let's not waste any time. Come on, Curly.
I sure hope Stanton can refine enough gas. We'd be in an awfully tough spot if he doesn't.
That's his job. Ours is to get the diamonds.
But the diamonds are in the caves of Nacros. The lion men won't let us in unless we bring their amulet.
We'll have the amulet today.
Just walk right over and take it away from Shamba, I suppose.
No, we won't, but Latembe will. To him, you're the big white medicine man, father of Nyoka. You need the amulet for its curative powers. Now, before he finds out you're only Dr. Meredith's twin brother, you're gonna go to his hut and...
I don't forget, Bwana. You speak true word. Shamba shall be punished. And the amulet. I get it for you, I chew medicine, man. My warrior hunt the lion. When they return, we will strike the war drum.
Shamba! 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 Lieutenant, go to Boulevard!
Looks like we could ford it right here.
It's shallow enough, but look.
We'd better not go wading today.
No, sir. I'm allergic to water.
There's a footbridge just above here.
We'd better take this one at a time. Which one of us is the heaviest?
Boy, I'm losing weight every minute.
Okay. All right, Nyoka. Come ahead.
Swell spot to throw old razor blades.
Shoot, you might hit her.
Hey.
make big trouble.
What?
Shamba make trap to kill Lutendi and his warriors.
What kind of a trap, Kimbu?
A water trap in the caves of Nap Rose. Shamba go with amulet. Leave trail for Lutendi to follow.
Why should Lutendi follow him?
He go to get amulet for a white doctor.
We've got to get into the Nacros and wreck those water locks.
What about those lion guards?
We'll have to get by them somehow.
You go back to Kairobi, Kimbu.
For Nyoka, I thought...
Little man, you've had a busy day. Do what Nyoka tells you.
Signal to open the water gates. Hurry! Thank you.
Where's Nyoka?
Money mad, ruthless oil pirates, and trouble to the land of the Tiger Woman. Crossing the world to help her, Alan Saunders, a thrill-hunting soldier of fortune, is constantly shadowed by the threat of death and has the most spine-chilling adventures of his thrill-packed career when he joins forces with the Tiger Woman.
The men that are causing you this trouble are my enemies as well as yours. And I promise to do everything within my power to bring them to justice.
Henderson work here, too?
No. And Mr. Henderson's in charge of all operations in outer space. Even Commando Cody takes orders from him.
Well, I hope we make a good impression.
You'll do all right.
Come in. Hello. Miss Gilbert? Mr. Richards? I'm Mr. Henderson.
How do you do?
How are you, Mr. Henderson?
Come in and make yourselves comfortable.
Thank you.
I've looked over your records and recommendations. They're entirely satisfactory. I'm sure you're going to be able to fill the positions we have here for you.
Thank you, Mr. Henderson. Exactly what will our jobs be?
Basically, the same as you've been doing. Adapting atomic power for rocket ship propulsion.
Well, will we work here?
Yes.
But you'll find working with Commando Cody involves a great deal more than the usual laboratory routine.
Yes, I've heard a lot about him.
And you've only heard of a very few of his activities. Everything that takes place here is strictly top secret. That's why the government insists that Commander Cody wear a mask at all times. Even the people who work for him must know who he is. He's out testing a new fuel for his rocket flying suit, but he'll be back shortly. I'll show you around the laboratory while we're waiting. We've got the finest equipment in the country.
Thank you.
are your new assistants, Commando. Miss Joan Gilbert, Ted Richards, Commander Cody.
Miss Gilbert. How do you do? To Richards, Commander Cody.
Their credentials have passed the Security Council.
Good. That's what I call getting jet propulsion down to a fine point.
Yes, and my new fuel has increased its efficiency considerably.
I was waiting for you to get here, Commando, to explain the urgency of this work. And since they're going to be helping you, I think they should know the whole story.
Certainly. They can work more intelligently if they know what we're up against.
Of course, you've heard rumors and stories of mysterious missiles striking the Earth last winter.
Yes, but I understood that was just a few meteors and another group of those imaginary flying saucers.
That's what we wanted the public to believe. But actually, there were missiles fired at Earth by a powerful enemy from outer space.
Are the missiles still coming in?
No, Commando Cody has devised a means of encircling the Earth's upper atmosphere with a blanket of radioactive cosmic dust.
Beg your pardon?
I won't go into detail now, but any missile or rocket flying through this cosmic dust blanket becomes so hot that it burns up before it can reach Earth.
Do you have any idea who this enemy is or where he's located?
No, he's the unknown factor in our problem. However, we feel sure that he's based on one of the planets in our own solar system, so I've been instructed to take the offensive against him. Our first step will be to build an atomic-powered rocket ship capable of reaching any of the neighboring planets.
Have you designed the rocket yet?
Yes, and I'm reasonably sure it'll be practical. The technical problems will be worked out here in the lab. The actual rocket will be built somewhere else.
And secretly. I cannot stress that enough. We can't risk throwing the whole world into a panic. Besides, there's also the danger of possible enemy agents already on Earth. I'm certain that I've been shadowed on several occasions.
I promise you we'll take every precaution.
I'm sure you will. Of course, the government will give you every possible protection. Well, goodbye and good luck.
Goodbye, Mr. Henderson.
Goodbye.
Thank you, Mr. Henderson.
I'll show you the designs for the rocket.
Do we keep trailing him?
No, I better report in. Henderson just left Commando's place. He was in there for about an hour. A man and a woman went in first and then Commando.
Are they still there?
Yes.
When they leave, break in and try to find out what's going on. I suspect that Henderson is starting Commando out on some new project which may again interfere with our plans.
See if you can find out how our bombardment of Earth was stopped. This information would be of great value.
We'll try it.
What do you think of the plans?
As far as I can tell, they're very good. But you've got some rather heavy structural units in that hull.
Naturally, Ted, it'll have to support an atomic power plant.
Yeah, that's true. What's worrying me is how you plan to assemble it. According to Mr. Henderson, we're going to have to do it on the QT in backyard garages.
Not quite that bad. Ever hear of the town of Graphite?
No.
Not many people have. It's a ghost town. An old abandoned mining camp out here in the desert. Nobody ever goes near the place, and it has any number of old buildings to house our construction equipment.
Certainly looks far enough away from everything.
It is. Now, we'll have to do some road work between these points. But it's just the kind of place we need. Well, that's enough for one day. Did you both come out in one car?
Yeah, in mine.
Why don't you let Miss Gilbert take your car, and I'll drop you off at the hotel.
Okay, fine.
Good night, Joan.
Good night.
Good night. My car's down here. Let's go.
what's that flashing light?
It's from a photoelectric cell in the office. Somebody just went in there. Hold on to your hat.
Somebody drew a line across here to a place called Graphite.
Yeah. They don't tell us anything.
No, it don't. I'll tackle the safe. You check the filing cabinet. Closet. Get in. So we never did get into the safe.
Mm. Wasn't there anything in the office itself?
Not unless that map of the town of Graphite meant something.
It could. They might have found some new ore deposits, or they might be planning some other project there. I'll report to the ruler. From Earth. Reporting from Earth. The governor of Manhenderson has been in touch with Commando Cody, and they appear to be planning some operation in a deserted mining town. Do you consider this worth investigating further?
Definitely. Any project Henderson and Commander Cody are involved in is very likely to be directed against us.
The cosmic ray blanket Commander Cody built has seriously delayed our plans to use Earth as a staging area for the conquest of other planets. Cody is our most dangerous obstacle, so watch every move he makes.
Go to Graphite, find some good hiding place and some means of observing everything that takes place. If there are any signs of activity, let me know at once.
Right.
You think they found anything?
No, we're probably all right this time, but I'll feel a lot happier when we get moved out to Graphite.
Well, we can't expect to be entirely safe even there, Ted. After we start moving the materials and supplies in quantities, we must move with the utmost caution.
We can't keep people from spotting the truckloads of gear we need.
Having everything possible prefabricated, the various plants will simplify matters. Then we can move it out there all at once and make the final assembly in a hurry.
Does that mean that we'll be working in Graphite rather than here?
A little of both. So we'll need some means of communicating. Excuse me. You can tell people these are official badges you wear when you work for me. Actually, they are two-way radios with a special wavelength designed for my use only.
Got medals already.
You're liable to earn them before we finish with this job.
Commander, we're ready to install the atomic pile chamber in the rocket. Can you come down to the barn?
Okay, Ted. Let's go. Atomic pile chamber.
Rocket ship. We better report to Varney.
Yeah.
This is Varney reporting from Earth. My men have found out that Commando Cody is building a rocket ship, probably for interplanetary travel.
We must keep Commander Cody earthbound. Destroy his rocket ship at once.
Break in, cut up that ship the best you can, and then set fire to the barn.
Stay here and cover me.
Hello, Joan.
I tried to bring you some hot food from town, but I'm afraid it isn't very good now.
Beats coffee and sandwiches, anyway. Boy, we've been... Hey, Commando, someone's in the barn.
I'm going inside.
Right. Seeing eye alarm sure saved us that time.
We're not out of the woods yet. Let's get out to the barn and clean up that mess. When you report to Mr. Henderson tonight, tell him we'll still get the rocket out Thursday.
All right.
Good night, Joan.
Night.
Night.
That's the thing that tipped him off.
Well, it won't do it again. We'll have no trouble in that barn the next time.
Well, what are we going to do next time?
The ruler wants the rocket ship destroyed. He doesn't care how.
that's that. We won't find that bomb till they're up 30,000 feet tomorrow. And it'll be too late.
Good morning, Clancy. Everything all right?
Yes, and no trouble at all.
Good. Drive Miss Gilbert to Graphite, then report back to Mr. Henderson.
Yes, sir.
Give us a call on your radio when you get back to the office. We'll keep you posted.
All right. Bye, Commando, and good luck.
Thank you.
Bye, Joan.
Bye, Ted.
Jets. Firing main jets.
So far. Let's cruise around easy for a while, and we'll try for some altitude.
Right.
There's nothing here worth taking. Let's go.
So, you didn't go with the others. Maybe you're lucky. Let's get back to the mine and get our stuff. We can leave her there.
Seems to be hanging together. Let's try for some altitude.
Right.
What makes you think you can get away with this?
We're doing all right so far, aren't we?
When Commando Cody gets back, he'll cinch this whole town, even this mine.
Commando's not coming back.
You're bluffing.
Commando won't think so when he gets to 30,000 feet.
That's ridiculous. That rocket will fly to any altitude.
Well, it might if it didn't have a bomb hidden behind its radar scanning screen with a barometer detonator set to go off at 30,000.
Level off. Take over, Ted.
Take her back to the field. I'm going to fly down and find Joan.
Right, Commando.
Well, somebody will find you here after a while. Maybe.
Thank you.
Yes, Joan.
Commander, this rocket is certainly all we expected it to be. It's well worth everything you went through to get it flying.
I only hope we can keep it flying.
Seems to me you ensured that. The gang that tried to destroy it was wiped out.
There haven't been any attempts to penetrate the cosmic dust blanket, have there?
No, but Earth is in mortal danger. We still have a deadly and powerful enemy in outer space. There'll be plenty of work for this ship. And for us.
Back already, that was the end of Commander Cody, Episode 1. I hope you're enjoying these as much as I have over the years. If you like, check me out on Facebook underneath Donald O'Malley or Don's Breakfast Cereal Show. Let me know how I'm doing. Thanks again for tuning in. We'll be back next week with Chapters 6 through 10. Good night.